Hello friends, so today we will be looking at Memento design pattern. So this design pattern is used to restore an object state to a previous state. So this Memento is an object which is just used to store a state. So it is a simple POJO kind of class having a state, simple constructor and a get state method. That's all. So this is just used to encapsulate the state. Now let's look at the originator class. So this originator class will be used to set the state, get the state, and we can save the state to a memento using this. We can get the state from a memento. That is, saving state to a memento means creating a new memento object with this state argument and then giving that object to you. Similarly, for getting the state, we call memento.getState. So we will be basically calling this method. So it will be returning the state. So this is basically providing you a memento object which represents the state, the current state actually. So you are trying to store the current state into a memento object and you are returning the same memento object. In getting the state, you just get the state from whatever memento object you have passed. Okay, so this memento object is encapsulating a state within it. So we are trying to get that state. Okay, and there is one get state method which simply returns the state. Set state method which simply sets the state. And state is a private member of this class. Okay, let's look at the caretaker class, which is the third class. It does nothing but storing the list of mementos, that is list of states. So this is a list of states. We can add one more state to the list and we can get the state at a particular index in the list. So it's just a list. So caretaker is a list. Our memento was the state. An originator is basically maintaining a state and it can save the current state in a memento and it can get an older state. Okay, so it can revert back to the older state. So this is the basic use of memento design pattern. I'm now telling you to revert back to a previous state. So for example, you can say what we do in a Linux machine, we take snapshots at regular intervals. So the snapshot represents our whole system, whole operating system. So it's like a snapshot of the whole operating system and we take snapshots at regular intervals. So we can revert back to a particular snapshot and at any given point of time. And our machine will be exactly in the same state as that time. So let's say I have taken a snapshot on 25th January. So on 26th January, I realized that I have done something wrong with my machine. I have installed some other malware or something. So I can revert back to the 25th January snapshot. That's all. So this memento design pattern is used to revert to a older state. So let's see the demo class, which is actually using all these classes objects. So we create a new originator, a new caretaker. We set the state of originator as state 1. So it's like Linux box. We are setting its state as state 1. Changing the state to state 2. And then we are saving the state of Linux box, the current state of the Linux box. So originator dot, we call save state dot to memento method. So this will return a memento object which will be representing originator's current state, and we add it to this list. So we are basically storing the state and in our list. Then we change the state of our Linux box again. Then we again save the changed state. We again change the state of our Linux box. We print the current state. So we just do originator.getState method, we call, we print it. So now we call originator.getState from memento. This method, as I told you, is used to revert back to a previous state. So we provided the memento object to which we want to revert our state to. So caretaker.get0 will return us this one, because this we added first to the list and we are sequentially adding. So we are passing this object here. So the state will be basically now changed to, reverted back to this state 2, which we saved first. So this is the first save state, and we try to print the state. So it will be showing state 2. So this println will print state 2. So let's look at this get state from memento method to refresh your memory. This get state from memento expects a memento. So we are giving it the first memento from the list, memento object from the list. And it's modifying its own state variable. So this is originator's own variable. So it's originator's own reference state, and it is equating it to whatever state my memento object contains or encapsulates. So whatever state I have stored, I am equating it to my current state. So I am making my current state to be equal to that, whatever I have stored earlier. I'm just passing it. Let's look at the class diagram quickly. So here's our demo class. It uses the system. So memento is at the heart of our system. Our originator is basically saving the states to a memento. A caretaker is one which is associated with lot of mementos. Basically, it is maintaining a list of mementos. And this whole system works together. And our demo class is using all of them. So this system, as I gave example of Linux box, the reverting to a previous snapshot, all those and other scenarios also, it's useful wherever we want to revert our state back to the previous state. Hope it is useful. Thank you, friends.